Hi teachers, let's say you want to show the definition of five key terms in a subject. You can do so using this interesting accordion style interactive morph animation. Let us say I want to show the definition of item number 3, I click on it and the definition shows. Item number 1, I click and the definition shows. Item number 4, item number 2, item number 5. Can you see here? It's a very beautiful way to show the definitions. And the best part is, there is no distraction whatsoever. When you show the definition of one term, only that definition shows and everything else is hidden. The setup is so surprisingly simple that any beginner can do. Of course, you need to have PowerPoint 2019 version or Microsoft 365. So let us dive right in and learn this beautiful yet simple graphic from scratch. I'm Ramgopal from presentationprocess.com. We share creative PowerPoint ideas to help professionals like you create engaging presentations. Here I am on a new slide. The first thing I'm going to do is to draw a rectangular box that has the term in it. So let us go to Auto Shapes Gallery, pick up the rectangle tool and draw a box like so, and then write your text here. This is term 1. Then choose a thicker font. Go to home and then let us choose 2cmmt condensed extra bold and let us increase the size maybe to around 40 or 36, whatever suits your requirement, and then have this to left alignment so that it looks like the accordion style. Now let us create a duplicate of this box by pressing Ctrl D and then place this right below the first one and then hit Ctrl D again and again. And let us customize this to term number 2 and term 3, 4 and 5. So we have got our 5 terms in place. I am going to make sure that everything is aligned properly. You can choose the fill color of your choice. Let me choose orange color and then to the next one teal color and so on. Now we've got our first slide in place. Now let me duplicate this slide and I'm going to write the definition for term 1. For that, I'm going to create some space by selecting the first box and moving it up using my up arrow key. Now, the reason why I'm using up arrow is I don't change the alignment of these boxes. Then let us select all of these and then move it slightly down. Now, that creates sufficient amount of space for us to write our definition. Once again, let us pick up the rectangle tool and let us create a box of the same dimension as the previous one. Let us go to shape outline and no outline. So everything looks consistent. And for the color, I'm going to choose a lighter hue of the orange color that I chose earlier for term 1. So let me choose maybe something like this. And then let me write my definition. Now I'm going to align this to left. Now we have got our term and definition. Make sure that there is not too much space between this definition box and the rest of the terms. So I'm going to select the rest of them and then make sure that they are positioned properly. So it is almost like they are right next to this definition box. Excellent. Now I'm going to apply morph transition to this slide. So let us go to transitions, go to morph and then reduce the duration to 0.5 seconds so that the transition happens fairly quickly. One of the key things that we need to do is to ensure that this definition box is always sent to back. So right click and say send to back and then bring the corresponding term to the front. So this is a small routine that we need to do in every iteration. So now we have got our second slide in place. We need to connect the first slide to the second one. So let us go to the first one and then say this term 1 connects to its corresponding definition in the next slide. By hitting Ctrl K, I bring up this dialog box. Then go to place in this document and then say slide 2 because we've just created this and say OK. Now we have linked the first term with its definition. Now I'm going to create a duplicate slide of the first slide. So I'm going to right click and say duplicate slide. Move this down and this becomes slide 3. And this time I'm going to move the first two up. So here I'm using my up arrow key and then I'm going to choose these and then move them down. And once again, I'm going to use the same box that I used earlier by pressing Ctrl C and using Ctrl V. This is just to save a little bit of time. And for this color, we are going to use a lighter hue of this teal color. So let us go to Shape Fill and choose this one. And let us change the text slightly. Now we have got our Term 2's definition. Once again, as I mentioned earlier, make sure that these are fairly close to the earlier box. Once again, right click on this and say Send to Back. Right click on this one and Bring to Front. And let us connect this one with the first slide. So let us go here and then say this box, Control K, is connected to slide 3 and say OK. Now the critical step is you go to slide 2 and link this term with its definition. So let us select this box here, press Control K, and then say it connects to slide 3 where the definition is shown, and we say OK. Now, of course, we need to apply Morph Transition to slide 3 as well. So let us go to Transitions, Morph Transition, and let us reduce this to 0.5 seconds. Now, let us review what we have done so far. Let us go to the first one and say Term 1's definition. It has taken us to slide 2. Now, we can click on this and it has taken us to slide 3. And you see here, it works so seamlessly. Now, let us do it for Term 3 as well, and you will understand the routine. Let me go to the first slide, right click and duplicate slide. Let us move this to the next position, which is slide 4. Now I'm going to write the definition for term 3. So let us select all of these and move them up using your up arrow key. And then create the space by moving these elements down. And then let us use the same text box that we had used earlier. Press Ctrl C and come back here and press Ctrl V. And then place it in such a way that we are able to get the definition in place, and then use a lighter hue of the color that you see of the term. And then let us change the text here and then move these elements closer. And as I mentioned earlier, you need to have this sent to back and bring this one forward. And since we don't have Morph Transition on this, we are going to apply that by going to Morph, and let us reduce the duration to 0.5 seconds. Now we need to establish the links again. Let us go to the first slide. Term 3 needs to be connected to the corresponding definition. So Control K and say slide 4 and say OK. We need to do that for the next slide. Once again, click here, Control K and say slide 4, OK. Go again to the next slide, click here and say Control K and slide 4 and say OK. So when I go to the first one and go to slideshow, I can click on any of these and I'll be able to see the corresponding definition. I can click on term 1 or click on term 2 and everything works beautifully. You need to follow the same routine for term 4 and term 5 to complete the diagram. Terms and definitions are an integral part of any presentation. Now let me show you some creative variations of showing terms and definitions using custom animation, so you can use this in any version of PowerPoint. These are templates taken from our comprehensive all-in-one PowerPoint bundle version 2.0. A variation of this is this one, where we show the term and the corresponding definition. Instead of terms and definitions, you want to show question and answer. You can use this interesting custom animation. If you want a simpler alternative, you can go for this template. Or if you want to just show 2 points, you can use this beautiful custom animation. All these and more are available in comprehensive all-in-one PowerPoint bundle version 2.0. I will leave a link to this useful product in the description box below the video. By the way, did you like our accordion style interactive morph animation? If you did, then you will really love our other tutorial we have got here that shows you how to use interactive custom animation in a creative way. All you need to do is to click on the link and watch the video and learn a useful technique. So go ahead, click on the link and start watching that video right now.